Apparently the kids can't get enough of this one. No.
No. It's round. And then we add like a little R on the end for some reason. Americans love it. I'm Felix Mallard and I play Marcus on Ginny and Georgia. A lot of people don't realise I'm Australian, and apparently that's because you all bought my American accent. So I'm going to tell you how I go from sounding like this to sounding like this.
Slip another shrimp on the barbie.
I didn't know about the shrimp on the barbie thing until I moved here, and it's such a big thing. Crocodile Dundee is like our national identity. I wanted to do the accent intentionally badly because he's an American and he wouldn't, you know, nail it.
You'd like that, wouldn't you, mate?
And then in retrospect, watching it back, I think I went really hard with the Australian.
I have a door.
I wanted to make sure we were cool.
You, it's so different. The way we place our tongue is completely flat, and we kind of talk out the front of our mouths, whereas Americans kind of talk into the back of their throat, and they keep their tongues at the top of their mouth.
I knew you were gonna shake my hand. Been trapped in this loop for 3 years now.
Most of the time I'm okay and I don't really think about the accent, but there are lines that pop up and I go, oh, that's gonna be hard. And this was one of them. I've been trapped in this loop for 3 years now. There's like a lot of R's in very quick succession. While we're shooting, every morning I'll get up and I'll do a series of vocal exercises. Round and round, the rugged rocks, the ragged rascals around the rural races. Jouai, jouai, joui, joui. Cor bor, tor dor, cor gor, pa ba, ta da, ka ga. Just warms your mouth up and gets you, me, ready for the day to be an American. And I actually stay in the American accent throughout the day. I'm not in a very thankful mood. But we can go harder, we can go mood. Not a very thankful mood, mate. The biggest thing for me was just learning how to talk like an American. Because Australians, for some reason, we go up at the end of each sentence and we make things question because I think we're all naturally insecure. Whereas Americans go down at the end of each sentence and they're very direct. And when they say something, they mean it.
Artists thrive under fascist regimes. Prague Spring.
Artists thrive under fascist regimes, Prague Spring. Which sounds fine, but when you think about it, you have to go, artists thrive under fascist regimes, Prague Spring. There are so many R's and there are so many like different little things to figure out that I read it on the page and I'm like, we're never gonna get through this scene. Luckily we did.
Hey, I'll be in the car.
Okay, I'll be in the car. We just throw that away. Any R sounds are just so much fun as an Australian to go, car, I'm in the car. Americans love that. The hardest words are when you have like a hard R followed by a consonant. Things like world, girlfriend are all really tough to say. I have to think about those.
You sound like a Hallmark holiday movie.
Hallmark holiday movie? You can chew it. It's like, it just sounds ridiculous.
You've never heard of the band Wednesday?
You've never heard of the band Wednesday? I'm kind of going a little bit hard. I sound like a bloke at the pub. That's another one with a lot of R's and a lot of like, it just sounds so different. You can hear how different the pronunciations are. Aussies just let it all go. We'll be right back.